Okay, friends, my name is Will Welker, and we're going to take a look at Blend4Web. And if you want to get involved with what Blend4Web can do, the first thing you're going to need to do is get it installed. And so that's what we're here to do. We'll go to the Blend4Web website and head to the downloads page. And what we're going to want to do is download the SDK. So go ahead and hit that download. I'm not going to bore you with the long download since I've already done that ahead of time. And when you download that, you're going to end up with a zip file, and you will unzip that into a folder. Now, this is our actual software development kit. It contains all the files necessary to install the add-on for Blender as well as get started with Blend4Web. And I'm going to go ahead and put it on my C drive. Once it is placed here, you'll want to leave it there because Blender will reference this location henceforth. So you'll want to leave it there. So once that's done, I can close that out and we're going to open Blender. And we will go ahead and install the Blender add-on. So we're going to go to User Preferences and we're going to go to File. And we're going to go to Scripts. And we're going to go to the C drive. And we will go to Blend4Web, Blender Scripts, just like that. We will accept that. Save User Settings. And we will close Blender. And then reopen Blender. And we will go File, User Preferences. And we're going to go to add-ons, and we will go to import export and Blend4Web and make sure it is activated. I just unactivated it. That's not what we want. We want it activated. That's right. Activated. There we go. It's activated. Okay, and I don't think I need to save, but just in case, I'll save user settings and close that. And we're going to check up here at where it normally says Blender Render, and we're going to change it to Blend4Web. And we are also going to check our File, Export, Blend4Web JSON, or Blend4Web HTML. And essentially, it's as simple as this. If I hit that, I'm going to save it to my desktop as untitled HTML, and that's it. I'm going to reduce that. And so here is my untitled HTML, and if I open that up, it is going to load, and there is my default cube, and that is how simple it is to export a three-dimensional scene from Blender into a self-contained HTML document. I will include useful links in the description, so go ahead and check those out and look for a video giving a tour of the software development kit as well as a tour of the interface changes you can expect in Blender when you install the Blend4Web add-on.